No Mai Anō. It's been a hit of the film festival. Local and international audiences have loved it. It's the story of a Tongan Kiwi family struggling to understand their father's tithing to his church. For My Father's Kingdom is the first Pacific documentary ever to be funded by the Film Commission. And as Mark Kreisel found out, it's truly a family affair.
Nerves in the air. There's 13 of us crammed into a small hotel room.
There's nothing bigger that's going to happen, I feel, in my life than tonight, you know.
Whoa. Oh, that's laying it on.
No, it's true.
The hair, the makeup, the fancy clothes.
Look over there, see the camera?
It looks so cool.
Vea Mafeleo and Jerry Tawamiti have dedicated 3 years to this project.
We're not married, so this is like the wedding.
So let's get this party started, Tongan style. Roll out the brass bands, pump the pomp and ceremony, kia kia and da'ovala. We're off to the movies.
I wouldn't be surprised if every Tongan in Auckland's here tonight.
Sporting royalty and actual royalty. It's the premiere of Vea and Jerry's feature documentary, For My Father's Kingdom.
This film, of course, is very close to home, and it is very raw.
We always knew that it would be really hard and emotional, but I didn't realise how far into the story, our family story, we would have to go to present our frustrations.
Enjoy.
Family, food, faith, fitting in. This is the story of Vea's Tongan Kiwi family, a family stretched to breaking point by their dad, 69-year-old Sire Mafeleo.
Were you worried that you could split the family apart? Even?
Well, I think we were all kind of broken anyway. So it was like more putting it back together in a way.
Sire supplements his meagre income with an early morning paper run and yet gives thousands of dollars to his Tongan church. His kids, raised on a Waikato dairy farm, have never understood.
Every year the savings is taken up for missionary.
No, your life just depends on money.
But life has to depend on money.
We were just like so frustrated with his drive to want money for his church, and for us, we could not understand his belief, his such need to give. We were so angry with Dad, like we were angry with Dad for years.
The road to understanding meant turning the camera back on the family during their most personal and intimate moments.
When we started it, I talked to everyone and we made sure that if we were going to do this, we were going to do it properly and we were going to go deep and not say any bullshit. This was it.
Two types of Tongans, the laughing Tongan, the crying Tongan. Guess what one I am?
It's about fitting in.
So I'm Tongan, Māori, Scottish, English.
Identity can be a cultural conundrum for Polynesian New Zealanders.
I see myself as a New Zealand-born Samoan, and I'm quite proud of both.
Mum has always told us to be proud. God, I'm gonna get emotional. And see, like, oh gosh, wait. I was holding off for it to happen. So Tongans always cry all the time. We're very emotional people, completely the opposite to Jerry.
Jerry was the fly on the wall cameraman Vea directed. They were also raising three boys.
Like it, I like it.
Okay.
Yep, and let's walk together.
Walk back.
And go. Walk like you own it.
You've got kids together and you work together. How hard was it to bring it all together?
Well, I'm crying.
So am I, mate. On the inside. But I'll take the five as well. Yeah. Oh, it's for my nephew who's not here.
Who was the boss?
Me, always.
She did the most yelling. Never gave me breaks. The film while watching these Tongans, the humongous feeds, and I'm just like starving. Get the wide shot.
No, you know the all-nighter.
Get the close up. Shoot the sequence.
He crashed out during the all-nighter.
Oh, yeah, I did too.
And I was like, you saw how pregnant I was, and so I had to film it.
Preparing it, eating it, food. Glorious food like you've never seen before. Both hero and villain.
I'm Samoan, and I thought we eat a lot, right? But when I went to my first Tongan feast, I was gobsmacked. Eh? I was like mountains of food on top. And I'm like, oh, we eat a lot. My people eat a lot, but you guys, like, that's crazy. That's a crazy amount of food.
So much food. Do you understand why? Why so much?
Because it's generosity. It's showing how much you love the occasion, the people, your guests, you know. And nothing does go to waste.
It's killing with kindness, though, in a way.
That's a good way to put it. Yeah, it is.
In the documentary, the family travelled to Tonga for the 150th anniversary of Sire's school.
I won. Them to see what I did here, because I have something there to prove for them. I think this is the happiest thing in my life.
It's here their old dad tells a story about when he was a young boy and ran away from school with a friend. The freedom was only fleeting. Sire was the one out of a poor family picked out for greater things.
Mafi, he said, come here. Then he robbed me 3 times.
He was the only one that could go to school. He was the only one that they could afford to send to school out of 10 siblings.
Yeah, Mom, I'm ready.
I think that's what we really learnt when we went over on the trip, was like, oh, okay, it's not about us and our feelings of abandonment. There's a higher purpose to what Dad was doing.
The higher purpose was paying back his school and church for the opportunities he'd been given.
I think a lot of Sayers' generation and our parents' generation, they know what real sacrifice is, you know, and so constantly there's sacrifices being made in order for you to live a better life. And so when you get that life, it's no longer about, well, it's never about just providing for your own immediate family. It's providing for and remembering the sacrifices that everybody else went through.
You know what we're going to go and do tomorrow? We're going to get your outfits for the premiere, okay? What colours do you guys want to wear? Oh, no, you have to wear either black and blue for Granddad's colours, okay?
Coco, we love a love with Daddy?
Yeah.
It's a film about family, by a family.
What do you think of Mum and Dad's movie?
Dad?
Are you nervous about taking it to a bigger audience?
I'm not. I'm not nervous because we told the truth.
Because it's not his family.
That would look evil.
It may have hurt a bit along the way, but it didn't break them. And as for understanding why their dad still needs to give so much to the church...
This film, of course, does not have any answers at all, but it's just raising issues and saying, hey, we can talk about it.
If we're struggling to pay bills, then don't give so much. And God's not going to get angry if we don't give a certain amount.
Us not talking about it, it's not working. You know?
And guess what? Everyone's talking about it.
Can I just say one thing? I didn't hardly cry, right? I managed to talk properly without sobbing. Yeah. So I'm proud about that.
How fabulous.